The National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease has been studying the efficacy and the safety of bacteria therapy in the treatment of eczema. Their phase 2 clinical trials have been completed and they were published in September 2020. Atopic dermatitis is an inflammatory skin disease often called eczema. It can make skin dry and extremely itchy. Rashes can form inside the elbows, behind the knees, and on the face, hands, and feet. 1 in 10 people in the United States will develop eczema. It commonly starts in childhood, and many people outgrow it, although some people, it remains in adulthood. Children with a family history of allergy or asthma may be more likely to get atopic dermatitis, and studies show 50 to 70% of children with severe atopic dermatitis go on to develop asthma. There's no cure for eczema. The treatment is topical steroidal creams that can only control the symptoms. These creams have to be applied multiple times a day. Common skin microbiota come from the genera Staphylococcus, Propionibacterium, and Roseomonas. In previous studies, they've determined that people with eczema have higher concentrations of potentially pathogenic Staphylococcus aureus. In mouse models, they have discovered that Roseomonas mucosa can be beneficial in treating eczema, and the researchers wanted to see if introducing this bacteria from healthy skin on a skin with people with eczema could be used to treat the disease.
10 adults were in the trial. They were given a spray of Roseomonas mucosa, which they were instructed to apply to their antecubital region twice a week. They did this for 6 weeks. There are 5 children in the study. They were given the same spray of Roseomonas mucosa to administer twice a week. The differences in the adult study and the children's study are that the children's study continued on for 12 weeks. Also, in addition to spraying the antecubital region, they were sprayed in other affected areas, including the face.
Bacterial therapy is cheaper than steroidal therapy, and in addition, it only has to be administered twice a week as opposed to twice daily. This will lead to greater patient compliance. Bacterial therapy works. 6 out of the 10 adults and 4 of the 5 children saw a 50% improvement in eczema. 30% reported improvement of quality of life based on the children's and family's dermatology life quality index. Through the course of the study, there were no negative side effects. This is great news for eczema sufferers. At this point, they don't know the mechanism to their success. They do know that treatment lowers the amount of Staphylococcus aureus on a patient's skin. They don't know, however, why it is that Roseomonas from people with eczema in a lab will make chemicals that are skin irritants, whereas Roseomonas mucosa from healthy individuals will make those that are beneficial. More research needs to be done to determine if it's the Staphylococcus aureus population or the Roseomonas mucosa themselves. At this point, the studies only establish a correlation between the introduction of Roseomonas mucosa and the lessening of eczema symptoms and increase in quality of life. Further study will need to be done to determine causation. To the 31.6 million people suffering from eczema in the United States, this study gives them hope. It is moving to phase 3, where they will increase their test population and also duration of the study. This has also led to using bacterial therapy to treat other skin diseases. If you'd like to read more about this study or learn how you can join phase 3 of the clinical trials, follow the links below.
See, it worked. It cleared up my eczema.